Hello everyone. Is anybody there? Okay, so let me Hi Khurshid ji, hi Sushma, hi Sonia, hey Shraddha. Thank you so much guys for joining in. How are you all doing? Hi Sneha. Hi Rani. Thanks a lot for joining in guys. Okay, so hi Simran. So happy to see you guys here. Hi Prerna, thank you so much for joining. How are you doing? Hey Shalini. Okay, so today I'm going to work on this wood plank, and I have a few things ready here. Okay, and I need okay. Hi Shalini. Hey Anita. Okay, so I think we have enough people and we can start, I guess. What do you guys say? Shall we wait for some time or shall we start? Okay, so I'm just sharing my video. Okay. Okay, do invite your friends and also please do share in relevant groups so that, you know, people will know that we are doing live session here. Hey Monica. Hi Shilpa. Thank you so much guys for joining. Okay, so we can... Thank you so much Prerna. Yes, I just love these supplies and we gonna use these supplies only today. Okay, so... I think we are good to start, right? Okay, so here first we need to prime this because see this is wood and we need to keep everything, you know, on top of this we are going to add what you're saying Rani, we are thank you so much Rani, thanks a lot, it means a lot. Okay, so first we need to gesso this because this is wood and we don't want our rest media to get absorbed by this, so first we will okay so first we will just prime this and I'm using white gesso to do so. My gesso is a bit dried, so that's why I'm using water. And I don't want to, you know, do anything on this because I want this to look natural as it is because it looks nice. So I'm carefully just covering the middle portion, this portion, as you can see here, using white gesso. This tape is kind of necessary because we need to priming is necessary in mixed media as you all know. Thank you so much Anita, thanks a lot for sharing, it means a lot guys. If you are planning to go with a darker shade, then you can apply black gesso. As of now, I'm still thinking which color I will choose. So, just for the safer side, I'm using white gesso. Okay, just a nice one layer of white gesso. And now we will adhere our this embellishment. So I have this wooden frame. Okay, hi Subalakshmi, I'm doing good, how about you? Thank you so much. Yes, Monica, you can also use clear gesso too, but I don't have clear gesso, so that's why I use white gesso. But yeah, you can go with the white or black gesso. Sorry, you can go with the clear gesso as well. So I have this wooden frame with me. I got this again, I just don't remember. I think iCraft I got this. So this will be my focal point, and then I have resin embellishment, and I was just trying, and you know, I found one piece that is exact of this, you know, middle circle. So I'm just trying to fix it here like this. Oops. Okay, I need to paste it. So this is how it will look, and we can keep it here. And for focal point, I'm using this Finaber mold. Hi Sangeeta, thank you so much for joining. How are you doing? So this is what my basic will look like, and I have this flourish kind of molds as well with me. So yeah, so this will be my layout, and now we will decorate. So whenever you are planning a project, first decide your layout and then go with the, you know, other things. So first I will do some stenciling part here. So for that I need texture paste. Okay, where is the texture paste? Okay, hi Vijaya. So here is a texture paste. And with the help of palette knife, I will create texture just here and there. Not completely, just little texture. I don't want too much of texture on my project. But if you want, you can cover your entire project with, you know, texture and everything. So here a little bit. And maybe here, let's add it here. So it has nice crackle thing, you can see here. So that looks nice on the project. So maybe here we need. So as you can see, I'm just adding very little texture, not much. Okay, so enough of texture paste. And you can use any texture paste, whichever brand texture paste you have with you, you just go with that. Just remove out the excess. Yeah. And now I will paste this here. And for pasting, I'm using heavy gel medium. Okay. You can also use PVA glue or whatever glue you have with you. You can go with that as well. So just little bit of gel medium here and there. Guys, do share this video and invite your friends. That will be... Okay, here, maybe here a little bit. Hi Pallavi. Hi Anita. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, guys, for joining. Hope you all are doing great. Okay, so I don't want, since this frame have very nice intricate design going on, so my gel medium is going into that, but that's okay. So here I'm going to add that in the middle. Okay, and now I will add this frame. Okay, and just in case if I'm missing any comments, guys, please do bear with me. What I have done. So likewise it will be, just need to, okay, and it's the perfect, you know, perfect circle. I need to add my gel medium over here as well. So when you're working with mixed media, just remember that whatever embellishment you're using, make sure they stick properly, because while coloring we don't want them to come off. So yeah, and this is how it's looking. And I have this flourish, so I will add them here, or maybe something like this. Nope, not here. Oops, my texture paste is still wet. Maybe here, and this one is like this. Okay, so there is no rocket science in mixed media. Only thing is that, you know, choose right elements and choose right embellishments and colors. That's it. It's not necessary to invest in too much of things. Use whatever you have with you. Just in case if you don't have this kind of a flourish, you can go with the wooden thing, or you know, in jewelry making thing also we get nice things. Hi Hina, thank you so much. Monica, thanks a lot. Shraddha, okay, and now I will add my focal as well. So this is my focal. Just apply enough amount of gel medium. Just add it here. And now here we need to add something, because see here we can, you can see it's looking very plain, or you know, empty. So now we need to add some fillers, and for that, thank you so much Shashi. Hi Asha. And for that you can also add deco stones, or you can also go with the, you know, granules like these. So these are tiny stones, so you can also use that. So as of now I'm thinking to use that, or yeah, you can go with the deco stones as well. So just take out little bit here. Okay, and in that I'm going to add my Mod Podge here. So I'm using Mod Podge glue because it dries quickly. So that's the reason I'm using Mod Podge, and just give it a good mix. Add a little bit more. And this will work as a filler, so our composition will look nice together. So just here and there we need to add now. It's very necessary to, you know, give your composition interesting look. It should not feel like, you know, some embellishment is going there and here and there. It should look all together, and that's where this filler works great. Just add them. Okay, what you are saying Pallavi? Monica and Pallavi, these are small granules. We we use them to, you know, to decorate our fish tank stuffs. So there you can get this. So this is basically, you know, small stones. See, just ignore my hand. This is basically a small stones. So my okay, yes Pallavi, that's what this stones is available at, you know, the shop where we get fish and fish tank materials. So from there you can get this kind. There are a lot of colors available in this kind of a sand as well. So just add wherever you want it. Thank you so much guys, thanks a lot for your support, it means a lot, trust me. Okay, so now I need a little bit here as well. Okay, so just little bit patience, we need to add this. And this really works nice when, you know, even if you are working on big size projects, this looks nice. Nazar Khan, what you are saying? This is not the place where you can, you know, promote yourself. So please don't promote yourself, guys. Here, this is, we are here only to learn stuff. Thanks a lot, Nazar Khan, for, you know, understanding. But don't post your business stuffs here. Okay. So, this side as well. So, just little bit here and there, wherever you feel like, just add that. Hi, Jyotirmay. Thanks a lot for joining. Okay. So I think that is enough here. Where else we can add? I think here, little bit here, just a little bit here. Okay. Okay, so I think this is enough, and I have mixed little bit more, but that's okay. I can use it later in my another project, and since it has Mod Podge, so maybe it will stay. Wait, okay. Okay, so I think that is enough, and now I will add where are those? Okay, I will add these water drops. So these water drops you will get from Crafter's Corner. Over there these kind of a water droplets are available. And again, I need, thank you so much, thanks a lot Shravan Kumar, thanks a lot Priya, hi Jyoti. Okay, and now I will add these droplets. Just to, you know, add extra interest to our project. So just little bit here and there. Okay. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot, Shraddha. So you can add however you want. Okay, it's not ready to stick. Why buddy? Okay, that is there and here as well. So whenever you're working, just remember that you know you need to give your composition like all together. It should look like, you know, everything is together. It should not look like disoriented, or you know, I am not getting the proper word, but yeah. Thank you so much, Sushma. Thanks a lot, dear. And maybe here, maybe one more here. And I think enough of these stones. So just I need to. And now I will just give it a heat gun thing because it should dry immediately. Okay. Okay, so this is what the final composition looks like. Okay, and now let's, you need to hear a little bit of noise of this. Hi Nina. Hi Jansi. Thank you so much for joining. Nina, you can watch you know this video again once this live finishes off. Thank you Monica. Thanks a lot Sneha. Okay. I think I have missed some questions. Just in case if I miss any question, I will just answer you guys after some time, because see in screen I'm not able to see each and every comment. Sometimes it just, you know, skip from my side, so just don't worry about that. I will surely help you or you know answer you once my live is finished, and I always try to, you know, do that. Yeah, so okay, so now for coloring I'm using chalk paint. So this shade, I love this shade. So I have this shade and I do have this color combo. So just let me know which color combo shall we go with. Hi Madhvi, thanks a lot Sushma. So just let me know which combo should we go with. So I personally feel this looks nice. Okay, I think this looks nice. I think Kurshid, you have some question. Please let me know. I have skipped. I don't know how it got skipped from my side. So I'm thinking to go with something darker, or you know, we can also go with the blue shade. The first two colors, right? I also feel the same. So let's go with these colors. Just give a little bit shake and. Hi Poonam, hi Jansi. I don't know, my comment section is it not allowing me to, you know. Khurshid ji, I have chosen. I taken out the other shades, but maybe I can add purple in this. Let's see if I can. We can always experiment with different types of shades, you know. Okay, let's take out little bit of purple as well. Maybe it will look nice. maybe, let's see. And now start coloring. So just use a stiff hair brush. Oh, thanks a lot, Tubby. I love this too. And this is still wet, so when you're working, you know, off the camera, so you can wait for some time to get this all stuff dry and then move on to the other process. But as of now, I can do that. Okay. Oh, thank you so much. Thanks a lot. Your each and every comment means a lot, guys. Let's take different shade, and I'm using same brush as you can see, just to, you know, achieve the blended look. But if you don't like the, you know, messy thing, you can choose different, I mean, you can apply colors using different brushes. Okay, and you can see this is still wet. Oh, thank you so much, Akansha. It means a lot. Okay. And just in case, if you don't know, at 6:30 today, 6:30, we have huge hop coming up for you guys. We have 31 sponsors from whom you will get a chance to win goodie bag. So don't forget to join us. So on 6:30, it will be on YouTube, and we are 21 artists, and we will work on a steampunk theme. So all projects are based on steampunk theme. So don't forget to, you know, join us. After some time, I'll just give you a sneak peek how my project looks like. And this hop is organized by me and Shraddha, Creative Ages Shraddha. So we have done lot of hard work, guys. Do join us. And the rules are very simple, you know, to join our YouTube hop. You just need to subscribe all our hop participants as well as sponsors. And you need to share all the videos as well. So you can see I am using a same brush and taking out different shades. Three different shades I have on my palette. So let's take purple as well here. Maybe here. And don't hesitate to try, you know, different shades of color. So that's the way we just explore. That's how we explore, until and unless we try how we will get an idea, like which color combo looks nice. Thank you so much, Akansha. Thanks a lot. Yeah, sure. I'm also waiting for 6:30 so that, you know, all our videos goes live. And there is lot to learn, guys. There is lot to learn. And you will get idea like how basically steampunk looks like. So 21 different ideas from 21 different, you know, artists around the globe. Okay, so here a little bit. Okay. No Kapoor, sorry, no Pallavi, this is not a hop link. Hop link we will share once our, you know, video goes live on YouTube. So that time we will share the hop link. And in description box, you will be having all the artist YouTube links. So, and you will have, I guess, 13 days to participate in this hop. And we have amazing sponsors, guys. Amazing sponsors from around the world. So, yeah. Just follow the rules and yes. It's a little bit here and there. Okay, so I think this is done. I don't want color on this. So I'm just dabbing brush because here it's very the frame is very intricately designed and my brush bristle is not going into that, but that's okay. Okay, so this is done and now we will just heat set this and see thank you so much, thanks a lot Jhasi. Yes Sushma, it's for it's from 6:30. Yes, Monica, there was little bit of, you know, confusion in hop timing and we have, say, 21 artists around the globe. So, everyone have different time according to their time zone. And that's the reason. Okay, so now it's completely dry and I need to add color. As you can see here, white patches. So let's add color over here. So in a while I'll show you what I have prepared for my YouTube hop, so that you will get an idea, like here maybe. So I think that is enough of this. Okay, thanks a lot Shraddha, me too. Let's add a little bit of purple. And you can see here, you can also use this kind of, you know, a light shade of chalk paint as a highlighter. So look at this. Okay. Oh, thank you so much. Thanks a lot, Shraddha, for handling. You are such a darling. Okay. And a little bit here. So this is not the actual highlighting I'm doing. I'm just, you know, experimenting with you guys. So that, you know, I will also get an idea like how shades looks. So just using very light pressure, as always, add your highlights. For adding highlights, you need to use very light pressure, just like, you know, how to say. I hope you got my idea. So look at this. And now we will add my favorite metallics just to enhance it a little bit. But before that, I will let it dry quickly. थैंक यू सो मच पापा। थैंक यू सो मच ज्योतिर्मय। So I think it's dried completely, and now we will add metallic. So for that I'm thinking to go with bronze, or we can also go with gold as well. Oops, I need my brush. Let's try bronze first. So again, take your paint, very little bit, as you can see here, very little bit of paint. Let me see if that works. Yes, that works. I guess it looks nice. I'll just show you. Look at this. So with very light pressure, we need to apply these metallics. Thank you so much, Nina. So look at this shine. Hope you can see. And the metallic I'm using is from Fevicryl metallic paints. And you can see the difference between this side and this side. So highlighting is very much necessary when we are working on, you know, mixed media, because in mixed media we add lot of elements and we need them to pop out, you know, and that's where our highlighting do its job. What you're saying, Akansha? Okay, for substitute I do have it, I'll show you. Okay, so in our apartment we have children's play area, and from there I have collected these, you know, stones. You can use these stones as well. So this is the, you know, look at the, it has very nice granules, so this can be used as a substitute too. So don't limit yourself, just explore. There are lot of things available around us. Okay, so here on this girl as well. So look at this. Look how project turns, I mean, immediately into a beautiful piece after adding highlights. You can also go with white metallics too. But for me, gold, these shades I just love to add. So I think we can call this piece a finished piece. What do you guys say? Just a little bit here. So look at this. Oh, thank you so much, Jyotirmay. Yes. So I think we can finish this piece because there is no space more, and what we can add more, I'm just thinking, can we finish this? Or you can also add one sentiment over here if you want, but as of now I don't have sentiment with me, so yeah, just a little bit here and our piece is done. Thank you so much, Shilpa. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, Monica. What you are saying, Gitanjali? Can we use white cement to make clay? I haven't tried, but yes, you can use, I guess. But I haven't tried that. So just give it a try, and if that works out, do let me know, as I would like to try as well. See, art is all about, you know, exploring stuff. So until and unless you try by yourself, you will not get an idea like how things will work. Because see, sometimes what happens, some things work for someone and some things don't work for someone. So it's all depends on your personal experiences. So yeah. So I think I don't want to overdo. It looks nice as it is. What you guys say? Thank you so much, Khurshid ji. You didn't ask me your question. What was that? I think I have missed a lot of stuffs here. But you have my WhatsApp number. Just message me anytime. I am always there for you guys. So, yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much, Pallavi. Thanks a lot, Shraddha. So, hope you guys have enjoyed this mini session of, you know, altering small wood piece. And now just add a hook over here and your wall piece, wall decor is ready. So before that, just add a layer of varnish and yeah, that's it. Thank you so much, Jyotirmay. Thanks Monica. Thank you, Shraddha. Thanks a lot. How about Tubby? I guess Tubby also loves it. Okay then, bye bye, take care. Any question guys, if you have any question, do let me know. Sure, Monica, I will just, after some time, I will click photos and, what you are saying, Gitanjali, metal colors are available in shop. How to make metal colors with gold color? Please tell me. Actually, this kind of Fevicryl is available everywhere, so, I don't think, you know, DIY is necessary, but yeah, on Amazon you will get pigmented powder, so from that just add a PVA glue or, you know, Mod Podge into it and your color will be ready. So I will just do little research and let you know, because as of now I never tried that. So just give me some time and I will let you know guys. Poshita, this live will be available once it's finished, so within 5 or 10 minutes this will be available again. Okay, thank you so much, Anita. Thanks, Akansha. Okay, thanks a lot, Shraddha. Thanks a lot, dear. Yes, Tushar, you can see this video again. This will be this will stay on my page, so yeah, you can watch this anytime, and I will also upload this on my YouTube channel. Just in case guys, if you don't know, I do have YouTube channel. Over there I post lot of videos, so do subscribe to my channel and wait for 6:30 our hop will be live, and here is a sneak peek. This is my project, so okay, I don't want to, you know, ruin the surprise, so but yeah, this is my project. This is the sneak peek of my project. Yeah, okay then. Okay, so I think I can finish this live, right? Okay guys, thank you so much for joining. Bye bye, take care and happy creating. Bye.